Hi folks, you might have seen this in the corner of some of the shots while I was doing the clutch cylinder changes. It's a little Kubota compact tractor, about a 16 horsepower B1610. This thing gets thrashed around all day long, and it's been used daily for the last 10 years or so in all weathers, and to be honest, it's showing a few signs of age now. Mechanically it's pretty sound, a bit noisy, but it goes along quite well. But I'll show you some of the problems we've had with the metalwork. The everything underneath is really solid stuff, but the bodywork is really thin metal, as you can see. So for example, there should be a nut welded to the back of that there. You can see that it's split and it's all rotted out. You can see the sort of rot around that mount there. And that's the kind of thing that is typical on this. And then anywhere there's a mount, there's a big split there. There's a big split there. The other side was the same. It's all fairly rotten. None of it's galvanised. And a lot of the rubber bushes are worn. Bolts have dropped out. Of course, the bulkhead, everything was moving. The bulkhead mounts were rotten. I'll show you that in a minute. Those outriggers that come off the clutch bell housing were loose, as was that outrigger there, which links up to the bulkhead. So everything's just been moving about. A few oil leaks as well, but in something like this, you kind of expect that. You can see there where the bulkhead was rocking and started to damage the bodywork quite badly. I managed to tighten up the mount on that side. I thought the thread was stripped, but actually it was just loose. Where the bulkhead's been rocking, you can see it's come close to crushing the wiring loom. It's been starting to damage it. I haven't found any breaks yet, but everything has fused out, so I've got some tracing to do there. This side I've done, so you can see where the black paint is, there's been repairs. So there was a split there like the other side, so I've welded that up. I've welded up that side. All the mounts there. So it is now absolutely rock solid. That's how it should be, so that's how we're going to get the other side in the end. Also made up some spreader plates to go over some of the weld repairs, just to help ease the stress there, because they're always going to be slightly weak areas where the metal's thin. And I had to weld the lug on the end of that outrigger there, because that had completely sheared off. That was how much movement there was in the bodywork. So as you can see, plenty to be going on with, but hopefully you should see it for a couple of years. And we are looking at getting a new tractor at the moment, something a bit bigger. That's the bulkhead that I've repaired. Top half of it was really good, but what had happened, the way this is made, the original mounts were just bent over from the same bit of metal. They weren't even welded at the side. So I've let in a new bit of metal where they'd rotted out, or the welds have split, and then welded all round and on the inside as well. So they're pretty strong now. So that's about it. Hopefully another 2 or 3 days work should have it done. I'm still working on the tractor. I've finished the bodywork repairs, it's all welded up now. So much more solid. Bulkhead's all fitted up. Everything rerouted. All the stays are in place. Just a few electrical bits to connect up now. the other wing is now repaired, had a patch let in there, and the side's been welded up where it had split. Also got all the electrics connected up, so we should have indicators, lights, horn. I think that's for a work light, which I'm going to fit. If we're lucky, it should start as well. Glow plugs for a moment. Out of gear. Here we go. Just like that. Sweet little engine, it's only 700cc or so, but lovely low tick over. You can believe the torque down the low end and what it will tow is amazing. Whoever designed that unit did a good job. There you go. So we'll finish putting it together and I can start on things like side lights that we're going to put on it. I've got a work light we're going to put on because I find that loading things on the forks at night or during the winter hours is a little tricky. And we're going to put some tail lights on as well. As you can see, the little tractor's got all the electrics working, apart from one lamp at the rear. These bulb holders are so nasty, they're brick part ones, made for serious Land Rovers. They're about like 99p each or something ridiculous. I bought some to see what they were like. I decided they were so awful they're not going on my Land Rover, so we put them on the tractor instead. Got to change that one, I've got a spare. They're so bad, the lamp keeps popping out. So I'm not very impressed with them, but I guess you get what you pay for. Up front, I put some little side lights on it, which is a bit better. And of course we've got proper working headlamps and a big spot lamp, which even though it's not fully dark at the moment, absolutely brilliant. That'll be useful on some of the tracks around the forest. All the bodywork's repaired, so everywhere it's painted black. It's where I've put new metal in and so on, so it's all really solid now. Before I could have done that, and the actual chassis of the tractor wouldn't move, it'd just be the body moving about. So really pleased with that. Should see it through another year or two. So there you go, just that back one to do, and we're there. I hope the video has been of interest and thanks for watching.